Hello everyone, welcome to Gyan Mimamsa. In today's video, we will be discussing the 12-week strategy for prelims 2021. As you all know, prelims is on 27th of June, and from today, 83 days, that is approximately 12 weeks are left. I hope by now you all have completed the syllabus, and now it is time for revision. Revision is the key, you know, because in prelims, when the options are closed and when you are well revised, when you have read the topic very thoroughly, then only you will be able to mark it correctly or you will end up doing a lot of negatives. So in today's video, we will discuss the revision strategy. In the upcoming videos, I'll be bringing the strategy, how you can appear in those 2 hours, what you need to do and what you need to avoid during those 2 hours. And some other things. If you have any query, you can just post in the comment box and we will be taking it up in the next videos. Also, we will be bringing videos for 2022 strategy and answer writing. So stay tuned. And if you haven't subscribed the channel, so please subscribe to get the updates. So about today's video, let's start. If we talk about 12 weeks, for those who are preparing seriously and they have completed the syllabus, I would expect them to go for 10 to 11 hours per day. This is the requirement for next 83 days. It would be very good time for revision. And you can divide your, you know, day into 4 parts. That is, you know, GS1, GS2, CSAT, and then your current affairs. If you are going for around 10 hours, 11 hours, okay, I would suggest go for subject 1, 3.5 hours, subject 2, 3.5 hours, CSAT 1.5 hours, and current affairs 1.5 hours. This would be around 10 hours per day strategy. So doesn't matter if you are a night fighter or you are someone who, you know, wake up early, but you should try to give 10 hours per day for next 83 days, so that in this time you can complete your revisions. How to revise? So divide your 12 weeks into 3 parts, 7 plus 4 plus 1. First revision in 7 weeks and second revision in 4 weeks. What you need to do, there are around 7 subjects. If we talk about economics, quality, geography, environment, history. So let's call history into 3 parts, modern, ancient and medieval, art and culture, then would be science and tech. So this way, if we divide, so you can have, look at it, there are basically 6 subjects, but if we divide history into 3 parts, there are 7 subjects. So from economics is the most important part. There are around 25 questions. Then from polity, 12 to 15 questions. From history, as I told you, there are 3 parts of history, modern history, 5 to 6 questions. Ancient and medieval, 5 to 6 questions. Art and culture, 5 to 6 questions. So history total, 15 to 18 questions. Geography, 12 to 15 questions. Environment, 12 to 15 questions. And then science and tech, 5 to 8 questions. So if we total, it is around 85 questions from this field. And 15 remaining would be some difficult questions, some one-liners, some factuals and few reports and these type of things, and few things you may or may not have heard. So this is the pattern. This is basically the pattern. So revision should be, as you see here, you need to master economy, master one more out of these 4. Science and tech you need to do with the current affairs, and you need to give master one more out of this polity, history, geography and environment, and you can go average preparation with the other 3. So depending upon your strength, you can play you need to master economics plus one more subject, and you need to be average at least in other three subjects. Yeah, current affairs you need to be very good at. So, as I told you, subject one, subject two, CSAT, and then fourth would be your current affairs. So, if we talk about week one, and so start with economy, polity. Week two also economy and polity. Okay, so 7 hours for 14 days, you need to complete your economy and polity revision. Here, what you need to do, you need to take two sectional tests, mock for economics and two for polity. So, four tests, two economy and two polity, along with the revision. And you need to analyze these tests. I will tell you how you will analyze. In third week, you need to take, for example, geography and environment. In fourth week, geography and environment. In week five, you can take modern history. And here, ancient and medieval history. In week six, here you will be continuing with modern history. Here you can take art and culture. And in week seven, here we will be taking science and tech. And here you can take remaining anything that is remaining. Like if you are remaining some topic of economy, then you can complete it here. So like this, 7 weeks, two subjects a day plus CSAT and current affairs. Current affairs daily, 1.5 hours revision. You need to thoroughly revise these current affairs. CSAT, 1.5 hours daily if you do. So within 7 weeks, you can definitely be able to get up to 80 to 90 marks in CSAT. That's good enough. So this is first 7 week strategy, that is revision one. In the revision two, same. The week one, you will take economy plus polity. In the week two, you will take geography and environment. In the week three, you can take modern history plus art and culture. In week four, you can take ancient and medieval plus science and tech. CSAT plus current affairs would be the same. You can reduce time for CSAT from 1.5 hour to 1 hour, and you can, in this time, you will do the previous year questions of these subjects from around 2005 to 2020. And again, as we did there at the papers mock test, we did their sectional mock test. Here every week we will be doing two mock tests full length. So in the above part, every week we are doing two mock tests. So in 7 weeks, we are doing 14 mock tests, two from each subject. Okay, two from each of these seven subjects, you are doing mock tests every week. So 14, and two mock full length tests in these 4 weeks. So 8. Total 14 plus 8, 22 tests would be sufficient for your good revision. And for CSAT, you can go for one test a week in 11 weeks. So you can get some 8 to 10 tests every week in total for CSAT. So this is more than sufficient. Total 22 for GS and 8 for CSAT. This is good enough. So what you need to do is you need to analyze your mocks. So for starter, what you need to do, you need to restrict your negatives. Point one. Point two would be, you target, if you are getting 80 to 90 marks in the sectional test, that is good enough. So if you are getting 80, so don't worry, it is good score, because you will be improving with the second revision. Then third part comes is analysis. How you need to analyze? Analysis is very important. It will give you what mistakes you are making. So for example, you are attempting like 83 questions, okay? And you are getting, for example, 21 incorrect, okay? And 17 you did not attempted, incorrect, total attempted, that means total correct would be your 62. And your marks would be somewhere around 110. For example, if this is just a hypothetical example. So total answered 83, correct would be 62, incorrect, for example, 21 and not attempted 70. So how you need to analyze the incorrect ones? Incorrect, you need to find out the reason. There are few reasons. One reason would be conceptual clarity related issue. This comes due to lack of revision. Second would be the factual issues. You don't know the fact, then you made a mistake. Third would be some intelligent guess you made and that got wrong. Fourth would be issue due to reading you know, error or understanding error. You didn't understand the question properly. So you need to work on these, okay? So conceptual clarity, for example, out of 21, you got 8 incorrect due to lack of revision, 4 incorrect due to, you know, factual, and then you got 7 incorrect due to intelligent guess and 2 incorrect due to reading error. So this you need to work out. This will come with practice, okay? And then if you are having issues with the revision, then definitely 8 question you didn't get correct due to revision. So you need to work on the revision, and we will have one more, you know, 4 weeks for second revision. So that will help. Factual error, if you are making and if you are just guessing some facts, then try to avoid this error. If you don't know the fact, then just don't attempt it. Okay. And if you are making intelligent guess and if you are getting 7 incorrect, then look into it, like which part you are missing. Like if you are not getting correct in economics or polity, means which subject your guess are getting more correct and in which subject your guess are not getting very correct, you need to analyze that. Okay. So next, what happens is, what I say, you need to attempt the mock tests in 1.5 hours. Don't take 2 hours, because UPSC paper is quite lengthier than any mock. Any institute's mock, UPSC paper would be lengthy. 1.5 hour, if you complete the paper here, then it will take around 2 hours. Okay, go for 1 hour 40 minutes max, like 100 minutes. And you need to practice to go for 3 readings. You need to practice to go for 3 readings for every paper. Why? Tell you. For example, you got in the first reading, you got 40 to 45 you marked. And you will be knowing that, okay, you don't know 10 to 15 questions. Okay, for example, you are sure that you may not know 10. So put a big cross on it. In the second reading, you will be left with around 45 questions to read. So if you go in the paper, I told you like 100 minutes. So if you go 50 minutes for reading one, then you can take around 35 minutes for reading two, second reading for these 45. So here you need to give a good thought. So give a good thought to these 45 questions. And for example, you are able to go for like 25 more questions from here. In the third reading, you are left with like 15 minutes and you are left with 20 questions. So you need to deliberate, you need to think, and then you can go for 10 to 12 more questions. So this way you will be getting around 80 questions. Okay. What happens if you don't practice the third reading in the exam, for example, you took like 1 hour and 55 minutes for 2 readings. In the remaining 5 minutes, there will be a good pressure on you. Obviously, exam would bring some pressure on you. So in these 5 minutes, what you will do is you will come to the pressure. You may come to the pressure and you will be marking randomly, or you will be making more intelligent guess that, okay, I need to mark. For example, here, as we saw, you are done with around 65 questions. So you will think 65 is less. So let's mark 10 more questions in these 5 minutes. So at least you should return 75. And if you do this, most of them will go negative and your score will reduce by 3 to 4 marks. And let me tell you one more thing, that if the cutoff is 100 any year, then most of the students who are preparing well remain in this category, that is 95 to 105. This is the place where most of the students will be, you know, stuck. So 5 marks means 2 questions. So in if in those last 5 minutes you made some silly error and you got even 0.66 marks, even one extra question negative, then you may be out of the game. So you need to be very cool and calm, or for that you need to have some time. So practice 1 hour, 40 minutes, any mock and 3 readings. One thing. And second is, you need to restrict your hand. Restrict your negatives. If you don't know, then don't think that this is just a practice set. Let's mark it here and I will restrain myself in the final examination. No, this is not going to happen. I'm very sure this is not going to happen. If you practice what you are going to practice here, you are going to perform. Right? Practice makes a man perfect. That's the key. Okay, let me tell you one story about Sachin Tendulkar. Harsha Bhogle was narrating this story. Vinod Kambli, he is thought to have a better technique than Sachin Tendulkar. And everyone at that time thought that he will be a better player than Sachin Tendulkar. But Sachin Tendulkar was very aggressive for his game, very much dedicated. The difference in these two was their attitude. Vinod Kambli was, had a lot of, talent, was more talented. He never faced any difficulty. Okay. So he practiced less. Sachin Tendulkar, on the other hand, was a good player, keen to play always. So he practiced a lot. Once what happened, he went on practice for 55 days straight without any break. 2 hours in the morning, practice. Then he used to play a match. Then again, 2 hours in the evening, practice. The whole day, his time was dedicated for continuously for 55 days, without a break. Now imagine this kind of dedication that made Sachin Tendulkar a far better player than Vinod Kambli. Even Vinod Kambli was more talented. So what I want to just say is, practice. And practice comes from attitude. So you need to make your attitude like that, okay, even if I know, no issues, even I have the talent, no problem. I have the talent, let's sharpen my axe. Let's make my talent even better. So practice. Practice is the key. Sachin Tendulkar did it. He's one of the greatest players. I hope everyone knows. So Sachin Tendulkar, practice, and you need to practice the mocks. And practice should be very, thorough. You should have given a good thought with your practice, and that's how you can definitely excel in this examination. Thank you. If any query you are having, you can email me at the info@gyanmimansa.com. You can join my Telegram channel, Gyan Mimansa. GYANMIMANSA AWP, answer writing practice, Gyan Mimansa AWP, and we will be sharing a lot of things there. And you can also, put your queries in the comment box. And I would like, if anyone is appearing in any mock and they can share their score with me, share their analysis, and I can give them personal guidance for improvement if they need. I would definitely like this. You need to share your score, share your analysis, and I can definitely help you improve. So if you want, you can just email me here. You can join my Telegram channel, or you can, put your queries on the Instagram. I'll be putting the link in the description box below. I hope this was a helpful video. Thank you very much, and all the best for your examination. In the next video, we will be discussing the strategy for 2022. And then we will be coming up on with answer writing practice videos. And obviously, I will be bringing 2 more videos on prelims 2021. What not to do and what to do during the examination. Thank you very much.